Now of a crime that has stunned a neighborhood and left a 5-year-old boy dead.
And the suspect in the case remains in critical condition after he was shot by police. News Channel 5's John Kosick joins us now. John, tell us about any new developments on this story.
Yeah, Leon, Cleveland police spent the better part of the afternoon scouring this thick green grass in front of the home here on Harvard Avenue, looking for the 11 shell casings. The shots fired by Warrensville Heights police at Julian Whitaker, the 31-year-old who was supposed to be watching these kids, and now the neighborhood is trying to come to grips with what he is charged now with doing. It was around 8:30 this morning when police were called to this Harvard Avenue home after a 10-year-old girl ran from it, her throat cut, to this nearby nursing home where her mother was working. There she told her mother the 31-year-old Julian Whitaker had cut her and her 5-year-old brother with a knife. When Warrensville police arrived at the home on the Cleveland-Warrensville border, Whitaker came out of the home with a knife towards the officers.
I seen him run out the yard, and I seen the gunfire, and I seen him fall, and he repeatedly got back up, just repeatedly got back up.
Inside the home, police found the 5-year-old boy dead from a knife wound to the throat. Now, during this whole thing, a car passing by was reportedly hit by a bullet. A 5-year-old in the vehicle suffered minor injuries from the broken glass. Neighbors were stunned by this whole turn of events.
It's unbelievable. It's upsetting to anyone, not only to the family, but us neighbors who live around here, to know that there's someone in our midst who is capable of this.
Neighbors say the children, their mother and Whitaker, only moved into the home about 3 weeks ago. They both worked as nursing assistants a half block away at this nursing facility. Putting the pieces together now falls to Cleveland police.
It evolved very, very quickly. All the officers involved were from Warrensville Heights. They're going to follow their internal protocol. We're going to follow our protocol, which is that we're in charge of the investigation. We're going to investigate the death and the officer's action in the shooting.
And police right now saying very little so far as what they have learned and uncovered in that investigation. 31-year-old Julian Whitaker hospitalized tonight at MetroHealth Medical Center in critical condition. No word on the condition of the 10-year-old girl who was cut early this morning, the one who set this whole thing in motion by going for help, but her injuries are not thought to be life-threatening. Reporting live in Cleveland, John Kosick, News Channel 5.
Thank you, John. But before you get away, let me ask you this question. Do we know of any problems between Whitaker and the child's mother?
You know, Leon, I spoke to a relative of one of the people that work with them. They weren't even aware that they were living together. And as far as the administrator is concerned at the nursing home, they say they worked separate shifts and there were no disciplinary problems with either of the two workers.
Okay, many thanks for handling the story for us. Well, Julian Whitaker does have an arrest record. We do know that. His latest arrest came in April of 2006. He pleaded guilty to charges of aggravated vehicular assault, drug possession, and driving under the influence. He was arrested in October of 2000 for trying to steal a car and carrying a concealed weapon. He also pleaded guilty to those charges, and in both cases, he received probation.